should have just gone along, Wood. Kept your mouth shut.
Bitch, who are you?
Take off that mask!
I'm somebody who's been sent here to deal with you big time, motherfucker.
Why are you doing this? name's Brick Bardo, my friend. Did you recognize his face? Did you recognize my voice?
Should I?
It'd be nice. Just goes to show. People just don't remember.
I ain't done nothing to you.
Not me. My brother. That's another story, isn't it, Davey?
You know me?
Come on, you think I'd do this to somebody I didn't know? Besides, it's rude to destroy a man's life and then not remember. Your memory. In a moment, you're gonna be begging your brain to remember.
Fuck you.
No. Fuck you. They're all learning, like you're learning now. It's here, Davey. Judgment Day. Atonement. The apocalypse, call it whatever you want, but it's here, and accounts are past due.
Help me remember.
5 years ago, you received evidence that my brother was involved in fight fixing. Since that's all he knew, it destroyed him after they kicked him out. Now give me the name of the four who gave the evidence. The four who traded lives to save their own asses.
I'm not sure.
Get sure, Davey. Get real, real sure.
Okay! Mike Johnson, Billy Munoz, and the girl, Connie something. I can't remember.
Pretty good for a dead man.
We weren't trying to hurt your brother. It was just part of getting up to sports.
You just got caught this week.
Wasn't personal.
Never is. He was innocent, you know. And that's just cause. That's between me and the devil now. They destroyed him, and that needs justice. I'll turn life into a nightmare, mister. Nightmares. They're fucking scared of everyone, aren't they?
They'll be coming here to see me in Vegas.
I have some personal invitations. And I'll be waiting, mister. Waiting to take all the last guy fucking souls.
Those are the guilty ones, Max. Let's bring them to trial.
I'll start with Brent Caldwell and bring him to you.
Oh, man, am I fucked up? Oh, Roy Leah. Nothing's gonna take away this pain. Liquor, drugs.
some comfort.
Is comfort anyways.
How the fuck would I get that, huh? I mean, really, look at me.
What would comfort want with me?
Some person blow it on me. That'd be nice and fine.
I could show you some comfort. Really. I'll take away that pain for a little while. Would you like that?
You can do that, huh?
Come on, I got some blow. I'll make you forget. Let's go.
To your room?
Of course. I got some time before I have to go to the arena. I'm fighting here tomorrow night. See? I'm the main event.
You said, you're a champion kickboxer, right?
That's right. Heavyweight champ.
Why me, champ?
Something about you.
Like being the only girl in the bar at closing.
Come on. We'll make each other feel real good.
Like the pain go away, huh?
Hey, I can try.
Be some kind of god, huh?
Got some blow. Come on. I don't have all fucking night, so take your drink. Let's go to my room. Now.
Okay. All right, let's just go make it feel all better. Done.
What the fuck you mean you're done? Hey, what the fuck? I'm not through.
Yes, you are, Brent Coleman. I'll have a new
Bardo, so glad to catch you in.
How'd you know it was me?
Who else could it be?
What do you want?
Not what. Who? I want you, Billy. I want you to come and visit me for a few days. See if I can change your perspective on life.
Who is this?
Someone who wants to see you very, very bad. Come out and see me, Billy. I left directions in your car down.
Crazy.
Oh, yeah. Crazy enough to kill your daughter if you don't come and see me tonight.
daughter?
Yes. Dear, sweet Alice. I got her right here. You want to talk to her?
Yes. Don't hurt my daughter, please.
I'll see you tonight.
Yes.
Okay, no funny business. You're likely to find your daughter's body parts hanging from hooks. Do we understand each other?
Yes.
Good.
I didn't do it!
Bullshit! You tell me where Damien went with the goddamn stash, I'll make you wish you blew your fucking head off right quick. Speak up, my man!
I don't know Damien, man. I just go up in the neighborhood. I never hung out with him, man.
Don't fuck with me, cocksucker! Don't want him doing that at all!
I didn't do it, man. I don't know shit.
Yeah, you don't know shit. That's why you ran my socks.
Because of those my colors, man. Oh.
You're a businessman, asshole. You give a fuck about your goddamn shirt color. Now, last time. Where's Damien in our stash?
I don't know, man. I don't know.
That bitch.
a lot.
Don't thank me, Mike.
You know me?
All about you.
What the hell's going on here?
When's the last time you were in Vegas?
Meet you at my place then?
I told Bob I had another business dinner again.
Man, is that chump ever gonna wise up?
He's 55 and desperate. Even if he knew, he wouldn't care. He's just afraid I'm not gonna come home. The day that happens, I'll make sure and have half his fortune in my pocket, and I'll check out of this rat race. I've had it with everything, to tell you the truth. I can't sleep. I've got bad nightmares. I get these fucking headaches. God, I just feel like some kind of whore.
Got the son of a bitch to invest in this corporation, and now the World Martial Arts Association is the biggest thing in full contact promotions. What more could you want?
More than this. Years ago, this was my dream. No more, Steve. I'm burned out on martial arts. Besides, there's not enough money in it. I just want a divorce settlement from the wrinkled creep I married and move on to another life.
But you paid in blood to build the association. Can you really just walk away from it, Connie?
I have to. Besides, I married a rich man, and in 6 months, I'm free. And the nightmares will stop.
Speaking of nightmares, Connie, how can you stand to make love with him, you old ugly bastard?
I think of his money. I kiss his money. I sleep with his money. And then I have you. I make love with you, and I feel like I'm in the real world again. God, I've made so many mistakes. So many people.
Don't think about it.
Make me forget, Steve. Make me forget.
To see you for a very long time. Sorry to interrupt you. I forgot what a cheap slut you are. I should have known you'd be trying to get laid. Things haven't changed much from Huntington Beach, have they?
Do I know you from Huntington Beach?
Connie, I just beat your boyfriend to death and you don't even bat an eyelash. God fucking damn, are you one cold bitch? A heartless, cold bitch. You see more than a few people die in her life.
Who are you, goddammit?
Your conscience.
What do you want, money?
I'm not like you.
Then rape?
I'm not like you.
What do you fucking want?
I want you to come to a party I'm giving. It's a small, informal affair with some old friends. I promise you good food and sparkling conversation.
Sure, I'll come. You seem like an intriguing man. Sounds like an interesting party.
Oh. It'll be more than interesting. It'll be illuminating.
Look. I know what you want.
You.
Let's just cut the chase and get right down to it, huh?
Down to what?
You want me, right?
I'm here, aren't I?
Yes. Just don't hurt me, and I'll go along with whatever you want.
Is that right?
Just stay cool. You know what I mean. Just relax.
Don't do something stupid, Connie. You wouldn't want to do that.
Just relax. Ah!
supposed to be the best. The great Connie Angel. The first female martial artist ever to be a professional male in full contact. Gorgeous to boot. Lightning in a bottle. Yeah, I've heard a lot about you. You seem to have lost something. A little speed, a little technique. Rusty sitting behind your big fat desk.
Just give me a minute and I'll shake off the rust, you son of a bitch.
I want you to remember everything. And you will. I'd kill you now. Really responsible. I have to learn the truth. I think you'll learn something too. And then you'll die. Billy, see you in a little while.
We're all set. No after effects.
Give our guests a half an hour to recover. Then I'll give them a taste of what's to come. The guilty should rise to the surface, I suspect.
Be careful, Brick. I mean, they're all capable.
I'm always careful, Max, you know that.
We won't have surprise next time.
Not my brother.
When this is over, then you let it go for good.
After tonight, I forget everything.
You promise?
I'll finally let go.
Then we can go on where we left off 5 years ago.
Such as it is, yes.
relax. Brooke will be here shortly to start the matches. What matches? Pardon me? Connie, I can't hear you. You gotta speak up.
I said, what matches?
Matches of guilt and innocence, Connie. You're all martial artists who fought professionally one time or another. You're all current or former world champions. Hey, Connie, you're each gonna get in that ring behind me and fight one last match. Match of your life. Because after that, you won't fight again. You'll be dead.
Who are you?
I told you back in the hotel room before we fucked. Just hold your questions. Brooke will be here shortly. We'll explain
that bitch up in a bar, and in the middle of it, she pulled out a pistol and stuck this shit over my face.
Brent Caldwell, WCK champ.
Yeah, that's right. Who the fuck are you?
Hey, I'm Mike Johnson, man. Hell, I held a heavyweight title 3 years ago.
Yeah, right.
PKAA, until they went out of business.
I put them out of business.
Yeah, I know you too. Connie Angel, this big-time fight promoter.
You got my daughter. Who the fuck are you?
Chump, I'm talking to you. Hey!
Huh? What's your name?
Billy. Billy Munoz.
Billy Munoz?
He don't look like Billy Munoz to me, chump.
Yeah, it's him. It's Billy, all right. I recognize him now.
I always wondered what happened to you, Billy.
Oh, come on. Fuck the reunion. Let's just worry about getting me out of here, all right?
I got my daughter. I need help. She's all I got.
Give me a break.
Help.
It's okay, Billy. We all need help. Can anyone get loose?
Sure. But I've decided to sit here.
Shut up, Brent.
Seems like you two know each other pretty well, huh?
Yeah. We messed the sheets up a couple times. Huh, Connie?
Fuck you, Brent.
You have. See, but you won't screw me again. Not like the last time. You ripped me off for 25 G's.
Who is this brick anyway?
Shit, I don't know. Why are they doing this to us?
All I remember is my fight against Wood Wilson.
Wood Wilson? The lightweight champ?
Yeah. He was the first man I ever beat. Knockout in the first. That was really something back then.
Well, you know what, Connie? You're still really something, even now.
Better start taking this seriously, asshole.
You know, I remember an inquiry about your fight, Connie. I got called from the sports commission to tell them about wood-fixing fights. That fight, I never made it to testify. They canceled out on me.
I had a call, too. I had a fight coming up, but they wouldn't give me my license unless I testify against Wood.
What about you, Brent? Do you know anything about Wood Wilson?
No, I was nowhere near Vegas then. Nowhere close.
Are you sure, Brent? I seem to remember you were here for some promotion.
Well, your fucking memory sucks, Connie. I wasn't anywhere near Vegas around that time. All right?
They're after more than just killing us. One of us has information that they want.
About what?
I don't know. Whatever happens here, we gotta stick together.
Can you help me find my daughter?
Yes, Billy. We get out together. All of us.
all of us, okay?
I think I can get my hand loose.
Hell of a trick, Billy boy. Yeah, I don't know about the others, but it sure entertained the shit out of me. What are you gonna do next? Pluck out an eye?
Billy, watch out!
Yes, Billy, look what you've done to your arms. Terrible, Billy. Nothing to do to your arm. Deal with damaged goods. It's life, isn't it, Billy? Damaged goods, that's you.
I want to see my daughter.
Shut up, Billy. You're not in a position to demand jack shit. Look, you just behave yourself and stop creating all these problems for yourself.
Why are you doing this?
Deal with you in good time. We'll deal with it all in good time.
What I liked about you, Connie. You're so fucking smart.
Please don't hurt me. Please.
Tell me what I want to know, Jack.
Look, Sam was the one who dealt with whoever was in charge of the fight fixing. It was Sam's friend, and I got my instructions from Sam.
But Sam's dead, Jack. Died in a car wreck 3 years ago. Got himself decapitated before I could get to him. So that leaves you. You were the state sports commissioner.
I don't know who was running the scam. It was Sam's friend, not mine. I just got my kickback and went along. Please, I'm telling you the truth. It was Sam's friend who was in charge of everything.
Okay, Jack, okay. See? I wasn't so bad, was it? No. And dying wouldn't be so bad either.
No!
What we're gonna try and do is establish some communication. Jack's comments about Sam's friend were pretty interesting. Wouldn't you say, Brent?
Hey, I could give a fuck, asshole.
Well, you'll give a mighty fuck, Brent. Because one of you four is Sam's friend. One of you four set my brother up.
That's bullshit.
Oh, yes, it's true. One of you set up the whole stinking mess.
Look, you got it all wrong. I never testified. I never been before a commission. I don't know jack shit about Wood Wilson.
But haven't you ever passed on a little inside information, Mike? Didn't you know about some fixing and try to get yourself in on it?
So fucking what? I tried to skim a little on the side with some dark bets. Who the fuck wasn't?
My brother wasn't. That's what got him destroyed. First his credibility, and his livelihood, and finally his life. One of you four was involved in fight fixing big time. My brother found out about it. One of you went to him and gave him an offer that he had to take or else. He told you to go fuck yourselves. Leave him alone or he'll report your ass to the commission.
Why don't you beat him to it? You fucked him royally. Now, which one of you wasn't? Come on, you can save your associates a lot of pain by coming forward.
One of you motherfuckers got me into this.
You're all guilty, Brent, but one of you is guiltier than the rest.
That's bullshit.
Who knows? One of you might even be a murderer, Brent.
How do you figure that?
Easy. I'll explain. One by one. Let's start with Mike.
Get up. We don't have all day. We have a dog show coming here tomorrow. Hurry up.
Hey, Mike. Kick his ass. We'll all go have a beer.
Okay, Mike. Here's the deal. It's simple. You and I fight till one of us is dead. You win, you and the others go free, I win, you die, and the others don't concern you anymore. Any questions?
Well, what about her? Will she go along with it after I kick your ass?
After? Jesus Christ, aren't we confident? Look, and don't worry, you kill me and she won't mess with you anymore. This is my deal. She's just along for the ride.
Let's get it on, asshole.
Five years ago, you tried to cut yourself in on a fix. My brother refused to go along. And they sent you there to talk to him. To convince him.
Look, I didn't hurt him. I told him if he didn't go along with the plan, there'd be people out there that would hurt him. That's all I did.
Really? That's all? Didn't you tell your friends that Wood Wilson was going to be trouble? That if they cut you in, you would take care of Wood?
I didn't do shit. I was young. It was all tough. It was all that money.
I bet it was. I bet it was. You told your friends that Wood was going to be trouble. But they went to see the one who eventually took care of Wood.
It wasn't me!
Well, that's what we're about to find out, Mike.
Thank you.
band, huh?
Mike, tell me what you know I'm going, please.
Fuck you!
Cut the shit, Mike. Tell me what you know.
But don't try to protect any of them. They wouldn't do the same for you. I know you told Wood to lay down against Connie or else.
Go to hell, you son of a bitch. I never said that.
All right, Mike. Have it your way. Have it all, Mike.
I'll talk to you.
You'll talk, Billy? Well, then come on down. You're some guy, Billy. Coming to Mike's rescue. I want to see my daughter.
Well, talk to me first.
No deal.
You want to see her skinned and hanging from hooks in bite-sized pieces?
Let me see her and we'll talk.
Come on, Billy, give us a little taste. Let me judge the quality of what you have to say.
No deal. Let me see her.
But she's already dead, Billy. She's already dead.
Oh, God, no!
Yeah.
5 years ago, you sold out, Billy. You threw a fight against my brother. Then you testified that he was in on it. Look, I know how it was for you. Your career was almost over. Your wife left you, and you had two kids to raise and support. You needed the money. It was a bigger payday than you'd ever get in the ring. I understand all that. I don't fault why you did it. God knows, I'd kill to feed my kids if I had. You killed my brother. I killed your dog. Here's for you. Listen very carefully. I know you're hurt. But you have to listen. Six-year-old boy. Now, nothing is going to happen to him. Nothing will happen to him if you can tell me who set up my brother. Who came to you? Was it Connie or Brent?
I never met him. Just a letter, I swear. My son, please.
You can't tell me who it was even though your son's life's at stake?
I swear nothing.
Have it your own way. Consider your son a dead boy. Think we only have two left. Come on down here, Brent. You got a big mouth. Let's see you do some talking with it.
I'd be glad to come up there and beat the shit out of your head.
You can come on up and try.
Go ahead, Max. Champion. I'm honored, Brent. Mr. Fight Fixing himself. It's not every day an amateur like me gets to go a few rounds with the champ. Sort of makes me a Rocky, don't it?
Fuck you, asshole. I don't know shit about you, and I don't know your brother. And I didn't testify about him, and I didn't bring him no fucking messages. So why don't you do us both a favor?
And let me go.
And I won't say shit about this to no one.
So you think I made a mistake by bringing you here?
No shit, Sherlock.
Why should I trust you? You're not exactly known for it.
I got a career I don't want to fuck with. You think I'm gonna risk it over those chumps?
People have died here, Brent.
You don't see me crying.
Jesus, you're one cold bastard.
No, I'm a smart bastard.
That's right. You've always been smart, haven't you? Always looking out for number one. You do anything to make sure nobody fucks with your career.
That's right.
But you were the one that came up with the idea, weren't you?
That's bullshit.
The money was getting real good back then. All those easy fixed fights. Huh? It's a great scam for you and the others. And you were guaranteed the world championship. Life was good. Only you heard that someone was going to put a stop to it, huh?
Someone was going to put a hurt on your lifestyle.
bullshit.
That's what it was to you, Brent. And that really pissed you off. Sure, the others said that they would take care of it, that they would deal with Wood. But that wasn't good enough for you, was it?
No. You figured those fools may be able to trust their future on some half-assed setup, but you weren't. Taking away Wood's license, his credibility, his freedom. That wasn't really dealing with him in your mind, was it?
No. Now, where you come from, dealing with the punk meant really dealing with him, didn't it?
What is he saying, Brent? You killed Wilson.
That's right, Connie. That's exactly what he did. He dealt with Wood Wilson big time. You killed my brother, motherfucker. Dealt with, aren't you, Brent?
Please, don't work out. Please.
My brother didn't beg you.
How could you know?
Because I was there, motherfucker. I was fucking there. And I didn't beg you.
Thank you.
my job. I was a nurse.
How was that gonna get you?
It took me out of my life. You showed me possibilities. I could be cleaning bedpans back at Desert Valley Hospital. Instead, I'm here watching some pretty damn exciting kickboxing matches. If you put this behind you. One more, Brick. Connie Angel is the final one. The bitch in her goddamn grave so we can get on with our lives.
Bring it to me, Max.
Nice, Connie. Then again, that's the way you are. Cold, casual. Poor Max. She really loved me. She really cared for me. I promised her so much. Now she ends up like this. Ain't that a bitch? Ain't life one son of a goddamn whore? Oh well. So it goes. Oh well, oh well, oh well.
But to do what you've done,
it was too fucking much, girl. It was too fucking much, I couldn't take it.
What are you saying?
Oh, God. Wood Wilson. I mean, I was Wood Wilson. I mean, I don't know.
You're trying to tell me you're Wood Wilson? You expect me to believe that? I knew Wood Wilson. I lived with him, made love to him. I knew Wood, and you're not him.
I know I don't look like Wood anymore. Brent fixed my face really good. Used a lead pipe on it. Turned me into a bloody mess. The prick didn't stop until his hands were too tired. He didn't leave me for dead. I figured I had to be dead. Modern medicine's a miracle, don't you think, Connie?
I was found and they saved my life. They rebuilt me, almost totally. I've got so many plates and pins and metal rods in me, I can't even go through airport security.
The sons of bitches rebuilt my broken body and useless face and gave me new ones. Not better, but different. That was okay with me because I wasn't Wood Wilson anymore. He seemed like a long lost brother that I once knew but could barely remember.
Sounds like you had a lot of brain damage, Brick. I guess I couldn't fix that, huh?
Well, I'm fixed all right. Now I'm fixed just right.
You're not Wood Wilson. The man I knew would never do what you're doing. He was the sweetest, kindest person. You're nothing but a child-killing bastard. But if Wood were alive, I'd tell him how much I love him and miss him and how empty my life's been without him. I'd beg for his forgiveness. I'd tell him that I did it to save his life. I figured if Wood got kicked out of the sport, then they'd leave him alone.
You were really into it, weren't you, Kai? I never knew. I guess it's like they say, love is blind.
I was more than deep into it. I helped set up the whole deal. Everything. I was the boss. Back then, I thought I'd make enough money, and then I'd get out. And Wood and I could just live forever. I thought that was the right thing to do. I didn't want Wood to end up a broken, busted up boxer with nothing to show for all those years of fighting. I did it for us. But Wood was such a straight, honorable guy. He'd never go alone. He'd probably hate me for it. So when the money started to flow, that's when things got out of control. I couldn't protect Wood anymore. I thought it was worth it. I thought it was worth it, Wood.
I love you, Connie. I always have, I always will.
I love you, Wood.
So how did it come to this?
It was my fault. Me and my stupid ambition. I'm so sorry. What do we do now? How do we make it right?
That's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to make it right, Connie.
It's over, Wood.
It's not quite over yet.
It's over! I'm going to the police.
By the time they get here, Billy's daughter will be dead!
You were right. Billy does have to be this
way. I've been waiting for this moment. It's a long time, Connie. I know in my heart. You have to. Take me down like you did my brother. No lucky punch. The first round knockout.
There wasn't anything lucky about it, but that was just better.
I can't.
Help.
him. I'll show you how it should go.
Remember this, Pascal. I thought you were Wood Wilson, but I was wrong. You've been Bardo. Because Wood Wilson died 5 years ago.
Thank you, Linda. I'll be there in just a moment. Don't worry, Billy. I'm going to take good care of your children.